Well, hey everybody, it's Shug here, and I'm laying in my updated Warbonnet XLC Blackbird hammock. Mine is a double layer, it's called the light double layer. Two layers of fabric down here, one is a 20D ripstop, one is a 40D ripstop. It's super comfortable. They also make a heavyweight double layer. The heavy double weight will hold a weight of 400 pounds, and they also offer a single layer hammock which holds 250 pounds. Of course, we got the full bug net. The bug net is removable.
If you're a person like me, you don't have to pay that extra 25 bucks or whatever it was to have a reverse XLC Blackbird made. So if I was going to turn it the other way, if I slept with my head to the left and my feet to the right, I just flip this top cover and that's going to be on the other side.
So now by taking the bug net off and just flipping it over, we're now in the what Warbonnet calls the standard lay with head to the left, feet to the right. Now getting in and out of this hammock with the bug net is really easy. The zippers move quite freely. I hear about people sometimes that have a little bit of trouble because your zipper, you know, can end up way down there. And then you get in your hammock and that zipper's way down there and you gotta sit up. So here's a little way to work past that. And if you have one of these hammocks, you'll get used to doing it. When you sit into your hammock, you're not stressing the zipper too much to pull it here. And then go ahead and just bring your feet in. And your zipper is right there where you need it. What I really like is the zipper now goes all the way up to the end on that side. Let's take a little walk around, look at the new updated XLC. This is the webbing suspension, which runs down. That's my double-ended stuff sack right there waiting to suck this hammock back in. The straps are one of your options. It's webbing and your Warbonnet buckle system. You come on down. There's a continual loop right here. You can also choose to have a whoopee sling suspension if you'd like. We go down to the full zipper. The zipper now starts at this end. There's this elastic band right here, and what that does is covers up this tiny little gap right there, right? Because the zippers end right here and right here on this new hammock. Now, it used to be on the old one, there was a toggle that held your bug net back tightly. So now we have this strap right here that holds your bug net and it goes to this mini beaner, and it's a much better system. Okay, so once we have that beaner hooked up and your zipper all zipped back up, you just take this piece of elastic and that just goes right over that little gap right there. And you know, it would take a pretty serious bug to want to get in there. Getting in a hammock with a bug net or getting in your tent, you're gonna get a couple of bugs in with you. What you're trying to do is reduce that and not have them through the night. How many times have you laid in your hammock with a net and you're slapping at the netting trying to kill a bugs, or you're in a tent, you're slapping the side of that nylon for those 5 to 7 mosquitoes that get in, and they usually just go to the top and bounce around. But you're gonna get a bug in there getting in out of your hammock anyway, particularly if you have your headlamp on at night, because what do bugs do? They come to your headlamp. So take heed. Now, like on all Warbonnet products, the stitching is impeccable. There's darts in the bug net where needed to give it everything it needs. The little tie-outs for your bug net here, they're Grogain. You got a mitten hook right there that runs out the shock cord. I use a hiking pole, particularly for this instance, just to hold it up a little bit, because when you use a bug net like this with a tie-out, you're constantly ducking in and around it, so you'll end up picking a side you enter. Normally, I'd come in from this side. Of course, Warbonnet, made in Colorado. The zippers meet right here in the middle. This is where they end up every time. I like it there, because either way you go, you zip them out, they go all the way up to the end. Now let's get it to the very end. Goes all the way to the very end and then back down there. That way I always know where my zippers end up when I close my whole hammock. And it's right up by your head, and it's pretty much right here by the label and the zippers is kind of where your shoulder wants to be in this hammock. Right? Even one-handed. So that will come all the way to the end. So when you want to tie your bug net back,
boom.
All right, as we go on around from the foot end again, you can see our bug net comes right in here, and this is what Warbonnet calls the foot box area. You can see I have a pad in there right between the layers, so your feet end up pushing out in this area, and you really get a nice lay. And what the foot box consists of, if you look on the bug net here, you see this seam, all right, and there's this triangular piece of bug netting in there that forms what Warbonnet calls the foot box. This is the famed Warbonnet shelf. I have a neck pillow, and that's the top cover just laying in there. Here's one new thing. You can see the zipper right in here, and now you can zip that all the way open. Here on the shelf side, I have it staked out. It's nice to have it staked out. You don't need to have it staked out. You can just let that thing hang if you want and not bother staking out, and everything will still fall in there, and you'll still have a shelf. So here I am looking at you from the zippers right here underneath the shelf. This is the shelf over my head. And so I can actually get out of the hammock this way. I can vent the hammock this way. My shelf is still useful. My neck pillow is still in there. Have what you want. It's kind of nice to have it staked out because it holds it up. But the nicest thing is I can reach out if I have an underquilt on here and reach out on this side and make adjustments. Reach on out here and take you in with me. Come on. There is my feet down in that foot box, right? So I can really lay, get those feet out there. That triangular piece of fabric we were just talking about, that is what creates the foot box. So I'm on a nice diagonal lay. There's a lay here in my head. It's well away from the bug net, which I love. It's up off my face. The idea in this hammock for the sweet spot is you want to have your shoulder right near this tag or these zippers. That's kind of where you're going to end up the best, particularly if you hook on your Wookiee underquilt.
Okay, one thing with this bug netting and having it staked out. If you first get this thing, you'll find yourself a little confused, ducking around it. Now, it doesn't need to be staked out. It'll just hang down on you. I find for optimal bug protection and having it away from your face, staking it out makes all the difference in the world. Usually coming in from this side to unzip and get in. Doesn't take a lot. You don't have to unzip it too wide. So you just sit in, duck. Make sure your zipper's where you can grab it. Get in. It's a Cadillac, a Maserati, a Mercedes, a Ducati, a Jaguar of hammocks. So this is for a serious hammock enthusiast, like me, the Lord of Lollygag. So what I'm gonna do now is tie my bug net back. So this is why I usually just have this little, I like to use a little beaner, because I can just unhook it and leave that on my stake and have that laying on the ground. And now, what we'll do is we'll tie the bug net back, and that's a simple way, and that's probably the way I use it most of the day, most of the time. So I'll just unzip the bug net to the ends. And you got your two Grogain loops right here I was talking about. Go back behind your ridge line. You tie that netting back with those two loops. Now it's out of the way for the day. So let's talk a little bit about sitting in this hammock. As you can see right now, I'm sitting and my ridge line is kind of dangling. But what I do is when it hooks loose like this, I tend to hang in my hammock a lot, Because one of the great features, and I think this is a total strength of this hammock, is with this bug net hooked on, and when you're tied back, you have a great back support. So it's really nice sitting here. But I don't want to look at this. So what do? So I have a mini carabiner hanging on my line. And what I do is I just wrap it 3 or 4 times like that. So it ends up looking, that's a 3 wrap right there. I'm just going to put one more. And that will keep it out of my way when I'm sitting. So now when I'm sitting here, that ridge line is up and out of my way. And I can really sit and do some good leaning back. I love this feature. And when you're done, try to remember to undo that, because when you lay back in your core bonnet, my ridge line is, well, that's not too tight. But with 3 or 4 wraps, it's not that big a difference. But if you can remember to unwrap that, at least a couple wraps, sometimes I leave one wrap on it just so the beaner stays, that's a good thing. So that's a little tip I use to keep this out of my way. So now we're gonna take the bug net off. So I'm gonna unzip both zippers on both sides down here. I'm gonna slide this piece back. And what happens is when we take the bug net off, if you didn't want to have it, you just have a standard, regular traveler hammock, which is just a straight ahead hammock. Only thing different is it'll have a zipper on the edge so that you can add your bug net back on or your top cover. So one thing, when I take the bug net off and I want to put on the top cover, what I'm going to do is unhook the mitten hooks from, and the shock cord from the shelf side, and also from the bug net side, because we'll use these with the top cover. Okay, before we take the bug net off, we're gonna unhook that piece of elastic right there that goes to the bug net and leave that hanging right on your suspension. And then the zipper comes down right off that end. And we'll just unzip the shelf side across the foot box all the way to the end. So we're just looking at a regular hammock now. But it's a quite comfortable hammock. Still my pads in here. Double layer hammock. Nothing fancy about it. Just a good hammock. Ridgeline still here, 112 inches, Amsteel ridgeline. For you purist, it's nice to have this option. But there you go. So now let's go into what you call your add-ons. These are extra. These are components that you buy to add to your XLC, like the top cover, like a nice underquilt, whether it be the Wookiee full length or the Yeti partial length. Also, the underquilt protector. So we're gonna look at the underquilt protector in, oh, the 3 or 4 ways it can be used. It still has the same function no matter how it hangs, but if you zip it in along with the top cover, and it's a full sock with your hammock and underquilt and everything hanging inside, then it's called the Chinook. There's the top cover sitting on there. 7 ounces, 199 grams. All right, I've hooked the top cover, and you can see it's just like the bug net. It has that, has this little loop right here that hooked right into that beaner. That's what sort of holds it on. Here's the zipper ends right here. We'll zip it up. That'll zip down for the shelf, which will be back in here. You know, your backside has the Grogain loop on it. That works just the same as the bug net. So I'm not gonna show you zipping up the whole thing. Let me get it installed and then we'll talk about it. So now we've got our piece of shock cord here from the entrance side with our mitten clips. There is the top cover on. So think of this just as the bug net, same thing, but it's just made of a ripstop fabric. Your mitten clips still hook into your Grogain here to keep it pulled out. Now, you just have a little vent there by your face. The zippers work the same. You end up with your shelf again over here. It says that it's enclosed this time. You still have your foot box here. Now, instead of being a mesh triangle piece of fabric, it's just a solid piece. You have a vent at the end. So, just like the bug net, same rules apply. Only now I just have a teeny tiny window by my face when I'm laying here. But you can also use a top cover and, you know, leave your leave it open a bit. All right, like that. That really helps. Still blocking the wind a lot. Here we are looking up toward the vent at the end, which normally in your hammock, that is the highest end. So, you know, that's going to little airflow come through. So the top cover, just like the bug net, can be unhooked and tied back. You're leaning back. You got that back support. Everything is beautiful. Now we're looking at the XLC with the top cover on and the and we're looking at the Wookiee underquilt installed. So having that on with your top cover. And yes, indeed, I call an underquilt an add-on because an underquilt is not necessary. But again, if you're really serious and you want to be warm and you want that comfort and you don't want to mess with a pad in your hammock, which work fine, work great. Most of us campers have pads. Eventually, if you stick with hammocks, you may want to go underquilt. So that's an add-on. It's not necessary, but it's nice. So now I've got the underquilt protector here. It's ripstop nylon. It's got zippers on it and some ties, and that will hang around my underquilt. What I like best about an underquilt protector is it keeps the wind from blowing in. And once in a while, a puff of wind, no matter what underquilt you have, will whoo, get under there and for a second rob your warmth. And it helps keep the warmth from your underquilt in. It might raise the temperature 5 degrees or so. I'm just one of those guys that likes my tarps a little smaller. And by that, I don't mean in the length, I mean on the sides. Because the beauty to me of hammock camping is waking up and seeing the woods. That's what I love about it. I like the view. I don't like waking up and just looking at some nylon. So the underquilt protector, it just has a couple of pieces of Grogan on the end that you'll just tie with a regular bow knot around the end of your hammock. Now, the underquilt protector, I like them kind of hanging a little bit loose. I don't want it pushed right up against the bottom of my underquilt because it might compress the down. And you sort of, in theory, trap a little warm air in there. I have a little space hanging beneath. It's not pulling up super tight against me in the way it's hooked in right now. When you start hooking up multiple things on your hammock, I've got an underquilt protector, which as you can see, is the same color as the hammock. And Warbonnet has three color choices. They have a great camo if you're into that. I think it's called Bushwhack. They use the olive green and the coyote brown. That's it. So when you start layering things, you could easily mistake that underquilt as your hammock. So you can look in here. This is my actual hammock. This is the underquilt, the Wookiee, and this is the underquilt protector. It'd be very easy to sit in that. So you have to sort of maintain a little vigilance, and when I get in, make sure that you're sitting in the hammock. What I'm getting ready to do with the top cover also can happen with the bug net. They work just the same. So I'm going to unzip the top cover from the XLC hammock, and what I'm going to do is zip it to the underquilt protector. Stay with me. All right, so we're inside. So down, my feet are in the hammock down here, right? So here hangs my Wookiee, all right? Here's the sock, which is now the top cover zipped to the underquilt protector. Same here. So the hammock, as you can see, I'm kind of pulling the edges. Kind of pulling the edges of the hammock. The XLC is now hanging loose. But you have to be a little more careful getting in the hammock because there's a lot of layers in here and stuff. So it's kind of what I would call advanced hammocking. So I'm still inside this big cocoon of fabric. A lot of people really like socks. They like being closed in. They like the way it cuts the wind, gives them some extra warmth. You have to be careful, and the only way you can know this is to experiment about your condensation level. Even though you got good vents, but a great way to do it, in this hammock especially, is open it up a little bit. You can even open it up under your shelf along here and get yourself a little
more air crossing through.
So now I've taken off the top cover, and we're just back now to the open hammock. Wookiee underquilt still on here, covered by the underquilt protector. Now we have the underquilt protector zipped to the bug net, and the hammock is hanging loose inside, exactly how we just looked at the top cover. Everything's loose inside.
The underquilt protector is hanging around the underquilt. Here's the hammock body right here. So we're hanging loose in there again.
Now I can hook the bug net back to the hammock and just have the underquilt protector hanging loose. We got it hooked back up now. Underquilt protector hanging loose, hanging around the Wookiee. All right. And the bug net zipped back to the hammock body. Personally, that's my preferred ride. All the links to everything I've talked about will be in the description box below this video. Make sure to go to the Warbonnet site and look at all the links at the top of their website. There's some called promotions and sales. Sales, you can often buy a hammock. Oh, like an XLC that's called a blem hammock. It means it's got a blemish. It might just have a stain or something in the fabric. It's not structurally unsound. It'll save you a few bucks if you want to go that route. And look at their promotions, all right? So if you buy a hammock and an underquilt together, you'll get a certain amount of money off. There's a couple of deals there. Make sure to check those out. A lot of people miss that, and you can save yourselves a few bucks here or there.